Hi, this is efficient server-based resource sharing strategies with new subdation facility project. In this project, the main modules we are using is admin and user module. Admin can able to uploading a document which can be able to received by the user. They have a search option for downloading the document. Here I am using content-based search. Based on the content, the file will be searching and it will be downloaded by the user. And administrator have a power to give access rights to user, as well as they can able to reject the user as well. Administrator can able to pushing a news and event separately. That will be visible to user in their home page. Let's see how it is working. For that, we need to attach a database. Let's show how to attach the database. First, you have to open the SQL server. Just give connect. Here in databases, in your project folder, you find one database folder. Just copy the name of the database. Here in databases, right click. Restore database. Here you paste your database name, select from device, search over here, give add, go to your project folder, select the database, .bak extension database, give ok, select over here, just give ok. Automatically here 100% is showing, is uploaded successfully. That's it. So here you can find four tables: events, file master, news and register. Let's see how to work with the project. Start Microsoft Visual Studio 2010. File open, website. Here you have to select the adaptive secure access folder. Be clear with it. Once you explore this adaptive secure web access folder, you have to find this option. You have to select this parent folder only, not this folder. Select this folder, give open. Here in APP code, one code class file is there. Just find out the options over here. Here I am using MD5 security algorithm for encrypting your password. Here I am using identity-based data encryption methodology for encrypting your files. Here it is used for data re-encryption. That means data dehashing I am using for decrypting the data. So here two methods are used, MD5 and identity-based encryption, two things. Here default.aspx, right click it, just give view in browser. This is your home page. Two users, user administrator, registration, you find the option called name, email ID. Here I just type my name, mobile number. Submit. Be clear with it. Definitely your internet connection should be on, because the password is not, it is not asking you to enter the password. It is generating a password dynamically. Here I give submit. First it check your mail ID is correct or not. Now see, my mail ID is inbox 3. I'll show this thing. See, I received one mail regarding the security code. Just copy this, delete immediately, paste it over here, give check. See, now inbox is 5. Once the mail is sent, it will be incremented automatically. Thank you for registering with us. Registered successfully. Back. I'll show the password in my mail. See, now the password is received. Just copy the password. Don't forget password. Just copy and paste it in your notepad or something else you want to save, means you just save it. Because if you forget this password, no one can recover your password. Why I say like this means, just go to register folder, register table. Here you can see the password is in encrypted format. So server, if a person holding the server means he cannot get the password. That's why I encrypted the password and stored it here. So the password is compulsory, you need to maintain separately. Okay, now I just try to log in to the same password. It says invalid authentication. Why? Because we need to go to administrator, give permission for the respective user. View users, see now the user is registered, user is displayed over here. I just give activate. Now sign out, user, password, login. Now it checks the identity again. So I received a mail over here for a security code. I just use the security code and check. Session expires. So just do it again. Login. So now I entered into the, use this security code and login into the system. You will find the home page like this. Now no news and events are updated. So I sign up administrator, login as admin, username is admin, password is also admin, A capital. So here I have option called view users. We already see how it is working, like activate and deactivate modes we have. Activate means it will allow you to allow the user to log in into the page further. Upload data. Here, this is the option for uploading your resource. Here you have a folder called cloud. Here only your files will be uploaded. I delete the previously stored files. ID is 1, running ID. Here document process 1, I just enter document process 1 and select the program on program table 11.txt, get data. So this is the file content over there. Clear all, close all, like that it will be. Here I give encrypt. The data is encrypted using identity based encryption technique. Here the data is encrypted. The button is invisible. In cloud folder you can see the encrypted content. I just give submit. Resource uploaded successfully. Now ID will be running as 2. View uploads. You can view the file data. If you want to download, you can download it. Pop up block. Hello. You can download the data because the owner is a direct owner, have the direct permission without any requirement. They can download their own data. Here I just enter document process 2. If I give same data, okay, 111, I give the same data, get data, what is it? The data content is already uploaded into server, duplicates are not uploaded. So you have to select unique contents over there, get data, encrypt. Wait, it is loading. Yeah, submit. Now I created 2 files into my cloud. Here, this is the data. These 2 are original data, so no issue. Okay, view uploads. Sorry, second one is not uploaded. Just file, get data, encrypt. Submit. This was uploaded successfully. Now we can view the view uploads option, document process 2, the same will be there. So you can download this. Next one is news updation. Here I just enter a demo news 1. Submit. You can enter any news, any headline, any news, you can enter demo news 2. To submit. Now enter 3 news, just submit. Event updation, here event 1. Similarly, you can enter any news over there. Here you have a calendar option to select the thing. Submit. Submit. So two events are created. Sign out. I just log in as a user. Same thing. It has to send a key and we have to verify that key. Check. Search results. Now you can check the news and events are scrolling. If you touch this, it will be stopping. For news, headline, date time, I mean uploaded date time, what is the news? Recent date will be coming first. Recent date and time will be coming first. Demo news 1, 2, 3 will be scrolling. Here event, 28 May is first, 25 February is second. So this is the thing. If you touch this, it will be stopped. So this is the news and event page. Here search resource, you can find out the data like content based research. It is not a title or header based research. If I give search means it will be displaying over here. Next one contains two, which contains? Yeah, patient. So I just copy this thing. Search it over here. Yeah, second process, document process 2. You select. Now you will receive one security key over here. Can find it out. This name called download data security code. Copy this code, paste it over here. Give check. Security code successfully updated. Download the link. You give download. Automatically scan file will be getting downloaded. So for first one, it's clear. So first one, you select. Yeah. Here you can see show. This is the second code. First you check. Second field will also be. So this is the thing. Thank you.